More Trump news this week. He issued another, not executive order, but a presidential order towards all federal employees throughout the United States, essentially, National Park Service, Health and Human Services, what have you. Stop talking. Just stop talking. Do not tweet. Do not get on social media. Don't talk to the press. Keep your mouth shut, and things are going to be okay. Now, what he is effectively doing here is one of the tenets of fascism: prevent the government from talking to the public. He wants to prevent scientists at the EPA or with any other agency from talking to the public and explaining things like climate science. He wants to prevent Health and Human Services doctors and scientists and representatives from informing the public about any health crisis that happens in the United States. That is effectively what he has done. If for some reason there is a new pandemic this week, as there typically is, there's some kind of flu, animal flu that does something. Right now, according to Trump's order, they couldn't tell us. We'd have to wait for it to come from him. That's psychotic. That is just pure psychosis happening here. Like, no, you can't tell them. I'm going to tell them. He's silencing the federal government. This is fascism. That's the only way I can think to say it, because we understand what fascism is. And so I'm fearful for these federal employees. I understand that some are fighting back and they're starting to clamp down on them. And God only knows what's going to happen to them once Trump finds out who they are. But overall, I mean, I'm interested to hear your take on this, because I'm still kind of just flabbergasted by the whole thing. I don't quite know how to react, because this is just unprecedented in the United States.
Yeah, there's absolutely no defending what he's done. There's no explanation that could somehow make it seem okay. I haven't seen any real attempt at explaining it in a positive light. Yeah, what he's doing is the most important thing is telling scientists that they can't share their findings with the public. And that, I mean, we are the taxpayers. We pay federal employees to do their jobs. Federal scientists are, you know, working for us, and they can't tell us what they find. They can't tell us that, oh, we found new information about climate change that further proves that it's caused by human activity. We, you know, even something like the USDA has instituted their own clampdown on their employees, and they claim that it's not motivated by Trump, but once again, who just became president, you know, you can make these clear things that he's obviously doing things behind the scenes as well as out up front. But the USDA telling their employees that they can't speak with the public and that they, you know, need to run things through them. In fact, just yesterday, I think Trump said that pretty much any scientists in the EPA now cannot release any information without running it through them.
Right.
You know, like they have to approve whether or not the scientific information confirms their propaganda or not. It's just, it's so dark to be politicizing science this way. I mean, people try and pretend that science is a political issue because climate change is debatable, yada, yada, yada. But science is nonpartisan. Science is based on fact. There are, you know, things that back up what they say. I think it's Neil deGrasse Tyson said, the great thing about science is it's true whether or not you believe in it. And the great thing about science is it's true whether or not you allow it to be released to the public. But that's the problem. If the public doesn't know what's going on, they can't make up their mind. They're going to just have to follow what Trump says. And it's just like Stephen Bannon. We may be talking about this later, but Stephen Bannon telling the press they need to shut their mouth. What Donald Trump wants is for everyone to only be able to listen to him. And that's what an authoritarian does. That's what a fascist does. You know, if you only get your information from a lying president, then you're not getting the truth, and you're not able to make up your own mind.
Right. Well, and you know, we talked about this earlier in the week here, articles and videos. 1984, the book. One of the things that they do is they keep the public uneducated by miseducating them, by releasing certain facts that are, you know, not necessarily true, or they're edited, or it leaves out half the story. And so that makes the people more compliant, more willing to believe what you're telling them. And so, and obviously in the case of Trump, more willing to reelect you in 4 years. So if he takes those climate change reports, takes out anything about, you know, man's activity in it, carbon emissions, things of that nature, and then just releases a bare bones report that says the climate is changing, but it's changed in the past, so have a nice day, they'll believe it. They'll say, well, this is a government report. They did this. the only good thing that could possibly happen, we've seen this happen in other countries in recent years, is that a draft report will get leaked, and then the main report will come out. And there are plenty of people who do go through and say, look, the main report cut out this line, they cut out this, they cut out this. Because we have seen this before. We have seen other countries attempt to censor climate science. So that's a hope. Maybe we can get draft reports coming out from, you know, brave employees who hopefully never have their identities revealed. Because, again, God only knows what's going to happen to them if Trump finds out. And that's what's scary. Now, I don't think there were any federal employees that had to fear for essentially their lives during the Obama administration. You know, good, bad, whatever you think of Obama, these people probably went to work every day and said, hey, you know what, I'm probably going to have a good day. I don't think anybody in the government has said, I'm going to have a good day today in the last 7 days.
Yeah, I think speaking of Obama and kind of leaking information, one thing is that we're already learning that the people close to Trump are leaking information. That's how we found out how upset he was about the Women's March and about how his mood just dropped when he saw those people. We're getting reports of information that we shouldn't really know about him. So there's clearly a lot of dissent going on. But because of Obama, we know that the White House has precedent in recent years of going after leakers, going after whistleblowers, and, you know, treating them horrendously. So I mean, you said, yeah, federal employees probably were fairly happy with Obama, but it's still true that he set a really dark precedent for revealing private information, private government information to the public. So I worry about what's coming with
right.
that.
Well, you know, and there's a difference with that too. There's classified information, and then there's these reports. You know, as far as, you know, people who did what Edward Snowden did or did what Chelsea Manning did, probably, you know, obviously not the same thing, but you do have people obviously in the Interior Department and the EPA who weren't going to work every day fearing that President Obama was going to come in and slap handcuffs on them. And I think that's the big difference with Trump. Now, these are people who just, you know, they just have a job. I mean, these are jobs you can just apply for and get. You know, you go to Career Builder in Washington, D.C., these jobs are listed on there. It's not like they're not handling classified information. They're not doing anything out of the ordinary. It's just a job. And now they have to keep their mouth shut. They can't talk about it. They can't say anything. They can't think about it outside of their little bubble inside that office. And that's what's so terrifying. We're seeing the censoring of the government itself. And again, this really is something that is unprecedented as far as, you know, just the average Joe worker is now told, don't say a word once you leave this building. That's scary.
Yeah. And another instance of the, you know, quiet leaking is that we just found out, I believe a report came out yesterday, that Trump called the director of the National Parks Service. It called him. He got a call, I think, Saturday night saying, you know, you need to pretty much go out and lie about the size of my crowds, because the Park Service was the one that was retweeting the photos comparing Trump's inauguration crowd size to Obama's from 2009, and they got in trouble for that. But for the fact that he would call him, waste his time as president to say, you know what, you need to back me up here, trying to force a federal employee to lie on his behalf on something so small, that just means that he's going to have absolutely no restraint when it comes to lying about anything else. I mean, this is laughable, but the implications it has for anything else is so dire. And, you know, the focus on climate change, while there are people who continue to deny, you know, 97% of scientists are in agreement that climate change is man-made and that direct action needs to be taken. That's why Obama and several other countries met for the Paris Climate Agreement that is already being dismantled by Trump. The thing is, we don't have time to mess around with this stuff. You know, by suppressing this climate information, Trump is causing, you know, just irreparable damage. And we need to act now, and we're not acting now, and we're going backwards instead.
Right. And the problem that we had under Obama was not necessarily that we were moving forward or backwards, is that we stayed the same path. The Clean Power Plan, which didn't go nearly far enough, according to scientists, according to Dr. James Hansen, the guy who brought climate change to the forefront in America, said, and of the Paris Climate, he said, it's too late. It's just too late. Hey, it's good that you're doing this. First of all, it wouldn't even be enough if it wasn't too late, but it's too frickin' late. We had 8 years of inaction under Obama. We had 8 years of inaction under George W. Bush. And, you know, we, instead of voting for Al Gore, the guy who this was his thing in 2000, it's just kind of sad to think of, like, what kind of different planet would we be living on today had Florida not screwed up in the year 2000? And again, obviously, Florida screwed up this year, too.